Let's go to Euro correspondent Ben Avery, who is in Milan, Italy. Ben, millions of people are being forced to adapt to new restrictions.
Yes, right now life is very different here, Pete. I'm standing outside one of the country's main tourist attractions, the Milan Cathedral. Usually it is absolutely swarming with tourists, but today it is almost empty. It follows a very drastic decision by the Italian government to essentially seal off large parts of the country.
Empty highways and abandoned streets. This is Milan in lockdown. The fashion capital and Italy's financial hub cut off from the rest of the country as the number of coronavirus deaths rose to 366, a jump of more than 100 in just 24 hours, making Italy the worst affected nation outside of China. What is happening in my city is worrying me and it is also saddening, this woman says. Today marked day one of a mass quarantine in a large section of the north. No unnecessary travel in and out, airports under guard and passengers preparing themselves.
Stiamo affrontando un'emergenza.
Italian Prime Minister Giuseppe Conte saying we are facing an emergency, a national emergency. More than 16 million people have been isolated, spanning the entire region of Lombardy and over a dozen other provinces, including tourist hotspot Venice. The latest figures show more than 7,000 people have contracted the virus, 650 of them now in intensive care.
When the sun goes down here in Milan, a city usually known for its nightlife is all but deserted. Pubs and nightclubs are no longer allowed to open their doors. Restaurants and cafes are forced to shut at exactly 6 p.m. And even when they reopen the following morning, customers are told that they need to sit at least a metre apart.
Even weddings and funerals have been banned, but one service that went ahead rather unusually was the Pope's Sunday address to St Peter's Square from a large screen. It's a bit strange, this prayer today, with the Pope caged in the library, he said. He too keeping a safe distance with a quick wave to the thinned out crowd. And measures are tightening across the rest of Europe, France now banning gatherings of more than 1,000 people, while in the Middle East, the Bahrain Grand Prix will be held without spectators. The virus escalating in the US too. 21 people have now died and more than 500 have been diagnosed.
There have been some importations from the US. The growing case numbers in the US over the last few days are of concern.
The Grand Princess cruise ship, which has 21 cases on board, will dock in California tomorrow. Passengers will see out quarantine at US Air Force bases with the crew to remain on the ship. In Milan, Ben Avery, 9 News.